man. Top of the morning, it's your boy JP the Beast, man. And this one right here is for my members only. You feel me? Because I see who really be rocking with me. You know what I'm talking about? If you really rocking with me and you listening to me right now, man, you on my channel right now. You got first dibs. You know what I'm talking about? Yeah. Anyway, man, I'm just waking up, you know what I'm saying? When I wake up in the morning, I usually wake up to some game, man. I usually wake up to it by myself, though, you feel me? But now that I got y'all, man, we can wake up to this game together, you feel me? That's what I'm talking about. Anyway, man, I'm just going to give y'all a little game, and you know how I be popping it. See, in this world, man, really do gotta be real. That's why I named my channel GP the Beast, another real story. You see what it is, right? Y'all see the comments. They coming from everywhere. Everywhere GP done been. You know, motherfuckers, you know, you gonna have haters everywhere. So somebody gonna try to poke out from somewhere, man. I don't know. And I don't really give a damn. Because the bottom line is, man, shit, I ain't never been no fake motherfucker, man. I just can't do it. I can't do it. It ain't in my DNA. It ain't how I roll. I can't do it. So, you see, by being real, look what it did for me. It actually put some money in my pocket, man. Ain't that some crazy shit? Just by being real. But in reality, it's been doing that. It's been putting money in my pocket. It was putting money in my pocket when I was pivoting. Because I was being real. Real with me and real with the bitch. It was putting money in my pocket when I was a drug dealer. Because I was being real with the game. You know what I'm talking about? I was giving people their love, man. I was serving love. This is what I did. I sold everything cheaper than the average price. I did it for different reasons. One of the reasons was I didn't want to chase a nigga down. I want a nigga to chase me. Nigga chased me so hard, nigga, when I ain't had nothing. I be like, it's good, bro. Go fuck with the other nigga. I'll be back. I'll be back in like 2 days. They be like, nah, nigga. I'm going to wait. Nigga, you going to wait? You going to miss some money. Nah, nigga. I'm going to wait. Yeah, man. You know, and I didn't make that much money. It's not, I made more money than the average nigga, but to the average nigga, he thought I wasn't making that much money because he like, this nigga must be retarded, bruh. Why the fuck is he selling ounces for $600 or $700, nigga? When ounces is going for $900, this nigga missing $200, he retarded. But they don't know I was not retarded, nigga. You was the retarded one, nigga. Because when it took you a whole week to sell a key, I sold three of them. I sold the first one so fast, nigga, because they kept coming, because they couldn't believe it. Why is this motherfucking dummy selling motherfucking ounces for $500, $600, $700? Is he retarded? They thought I was retarded too. But some niggas thought I had the plug. I ain't had no plug. I wish I had the plug. I ain't never been one of them niggas where, you know, you buy five keys and the nigga front you five, or you buy 10 and nigga front you 10. I ain't never had that. If I had that, I probably would have ruled the world. I probably would have had life in motherfucking in the feds, because a whole lot of niggas had life in the feds. But anyway, that was just some game right there. You know? Niggas told me, nigga, when I got out the pen, nigga, you ain't gonna be able to rap, nigga, you too old, nigga. You know what I'm talking about? Nigga, I could do what I wanna do, man. Niggas lie, man, but the numbers don't. And even if I can't do that, what? Guess what I do? I find another lane. I find another lane to get in, fit in, and take over. I'm one of the first, nigga, to do a whole lot of shit in Sacramento. Yeah, one of the first. One of the first to go to the feds. I'm the nigga that changed the name from Sacramento to Macramento. You know what I'm talking about? Yeah. All that type of shit. One of the first niggas to be thugging, nigga, and become a pimp, nigga. When I became a pimp, pimps was soft. Nigga, they used to look at them like, nigga, you know what I mean? With high heel boots, nigga, and big hats, nigga, and long coats, nigga, looking hella funny and fly with a bunch of colors and shit. Yeah, I didn't do that. I came in the game GP the Beast, nigga, dressing like I dress, thugging, and let a nigga know, bro, you keep fucking with that bitch right there, this bitch right there, you keep fucking with her, and nigga, I'ma knock your ass out because you ain't got a bitch out here. Now, I understand the rules is, nigga, we can sweat each other's bitches, but where's your bitch? And since you don't have one, nigga, you fucking with my money right now, nigga. So, nigga, fuck with that bitch one more time, nigga. And I'ma knock your ass out. And them niggas said, oh my God, nigga, you're a gang member. You're not a pimp. Call it what you want, nigga. It's pimping right now, nigga. It's money out here and I'm about to get mine. You know what I'm saying? And I start going after nothing but white bitches. That's why the police hate me so much. Nigga, I had a fleet of white bitches. You know what I'm talking about? That's all I fucked with. Not a few superstar black bitches. You know what I mean? Superstar, though, gotta be exotic. You know what I mean? But the bottom line is, whatever you do, man, you try to be the best at it. When I was in prison, I needed income. So I started writing books. I figured like this was the only way I'm gonna get some money, man. I gotta write a book, cause I'm stuck. And there's a whole lot of free paper around here in these motherfucking classes. And I'm finna capitalize on this shit. So I started writing, I made a rule. I'm gonna write 10 pages a day. And I did that. Cause I knew if I wrote 10 pages a day in 30 days, nigga, I'd be done wrote 300 pages. But I also knew that I could stop around 200. And so that means, you'll figure it out, I wrote a book every motherfucking month. That's why I ended up writing 64 books while I was in prison. And I ended up self-publishing 34 of them. Now, I'm turning them into audiobooks. And I still got 30 more books to self-publish. You know, I've been called selfish. You know what I'm saying? And at first, it used to hurt me. But I'm like, you know what? I probably am selfish. Because, nigga, I'm a self-made type of nigga. You know what I'm talking about? I self-publish my own books. I'm self-employed. And I know if I don't do this shit for myself, how I'm gonna be able to help y'all? How I'm gonna be able to help anybody else? You have to be selfish in the beginning. It's okay to be selfish. Don't let a motherfucker try to bring you down because you trying to bring yourself up. It's okay, man. It's okay to not care what they think about you. It's okay. Because they need to understand who you is and what your mission is and what your focus is. If they don't understand that and they don't see that, that's okay. You can't force people to see what you see. You can't force people to try to understand you. Only you know you. Only you can understand you. If you believe it in your head that it's right, then do it. But if too many people is telling you it's wrong, then it could be wrong. But the bottom line is, I always ask myself, what am I doing? Am I hurting you? Did I fuck your bitch? Do I owe you some money? Because if I ain't fucked your bitch, I owe you some money. Nigga, it's no reason for you to be hating me. If you hating me for me, then nigga, I ain't got none of that shit. Nigga, I'm not finna change me for you, nigga. That been me for too long. You ain't gotta fuck with me, and I ain't gotta fuck with you. The way this world is right now, nigga, you gotta make decisions. It don't matter who it is. You gotta make decisions. You gotta wake up to your peace, bruh. You gotta have your peace. You know what I'm talking about? If you ain't got your peace, bruh, it's bad. I feel like anything that makes me uncomfortable, nigga, I'm trying to get the fuck away from it. I'm trying to get far away from it as possible. I'm kicking it out the door, nigga. I'm kicking it out the car. You know what I'm talking about? That's what I really went to jail for. Kicking a bitch out the car. But they turned that shit around, nigga, and made it bad. But that's what they gonna do. They gonna make it bad. It ain't never gonna be good. You know what I'm talking about? We was born in a white man's world. And the white man got the love. And the black man don't get no love. But It do get better though. It keep getting better because we keep making it better. We too motherfucking talented not to make it better. Nigga, we was able to rap too motherfucking good. They thought that shit wasn't gonna go nowhere. We was able to sing too motherfucking good. We able to dance too motherfucking good. We got flavors too mother. That swag is too motherfucking good. You know what I'm talking about? We are the innovators of this shit. You know what I'm talking about? Nigga, hella agile, hella athletic. You know what I'm talking about? Hella intelligent, hella smart. You know what I'm saying? Anything we fuck gonna turn black. Ain't no turning back. You know what I'm talking about? Yeah, any kind of race, nigga. Any kind of race, nigga. Don't let us get the pussy, nigga. The baby coming out black and it's over with. You know what I'm talking about? But it's gonna bring a whole lot of flavor to the family, though. You know what I'm talking about? We're gonna be all right. Shout it out. So, yeah. GP the Beast, man. Yeah. But I ain't gotta talk about myself. Usually other niggas talk about me. But I'm fucking with y'all, man. Y'all the members. I'm fucking with the members because the members is fucking with me. I'm fucking with the other motherfuckers that's fucking with me too, though, because y'all fucking with me too. You nigga, y'all to fuck with me too, but nigga, y'all need to fuck with me tougher. Y'all need to become a member, nigga. Come fuck with your boy on some membership type shit. Nigga, let's get this shit together, nigga, and go all the way to the top. Because that's what I'm trying to do. I'm trying to go to the top. And I'm trying to take you with me. Shout it out. See this book right here, Multiple Income, by me, the author, Gennaro Patterson. This is a book you need to go get. If you're trying to start leveling up your game, you're ready to start getting some money every month, you know what I mean? From $1,000, $5,000, $10,000 a month, first you need to do is read this book. This book gonna give you some game, and we can chop it up about it. Any type of questions you got. Multiple income. It's gonna give you the game that I got to show you. You see I got multiple things going on. You see I got the books. You see I got the show. You see I got the music. You see I got the dog grooming. Peep it out. I'm gonna show you this game, man, because I want to see you win. Go get it. You can get it on Amazon.com and you can order it on ebook. It's only like $2.99. Get the book. It's worth it. Shout it out.